Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see what is the basic difference between sequential circuit and combinational circuit. Till now, whatever we have studied, those are combinational circuit. That means if there is a change in an input, there is a sudden change in an output. So basically, output gets changed accordingly the input is changing. That is called as a combinational circuit. That means the output is completely depend on the present input. But what if the output is not depend only on the present input but the past outputs also? Then that circuit is called as a sequential circuit. So let's see the block diagram of a sequential circuit. So here, by looking at the diagram, you can differentiate between, basically this diagram represents the sequential circuit where it is a combination of a combinational logic circuits and the memory element. Now if you consider only combinational circuit, for example a logic gate which we have studied, so depending on the input, the combinational circuit will produce an output. So that means whatever is the change in the input, that change will be reflected in the output immediately. But when it comes to the sequential circuit, the combinational circuit's output is stored in a memory element, and when the output is produced, now this particular system can be reflected by this. Input is given and there will be output of the combinational circuit. But if that output is stored and that can be used as a feedback and the input to the combinational circuit, then this particular output can be called as an output of a sequential circuit, because now this output is depend on the present input as well as the past output, which is a feedback by using the memory limit. For example, let's take an example of an AND gate. For example, your combination logic circuit is nothing but AND gate. That means for a 1 and 0, your output should be 1. So if here the input is 1, your output should be 1. Now here also you are getting the output is equal to 1. That output 1 will be stored as a in a memory element as a 1, and that 1 can be given as an input. So here also you are getting 1. So again 1 and 1 as an input, your output will remain 1. So that means this output is depend on the input 1 and the output which we have produced, and that is given to the combinational logic circuit as a, this is also present input, but this present input is nothing but the past output. So if the output of the circuit is depend on the present input as well as the past output, then circuit is called as a sequential circuit. So here we have some example: adder, subtractor, multiplexer, demultiplexer. These are the examples of combinational circuit. That means there will be immediate change in an output state if there is a change in an input. But sequential circuit like shift register, flip-flop, counters, they store the element, they store the bit memory. So basically they have the memory element as additional component, you can say. And that memory element is utilized to store the bit information, and that bit information can be provided as an input. So depending on the present input and that stored bit information can be utilized as an input, and output will be produced accordingly. So such kind of circuits are known as a sequential circuits. In sequential circuits also we have a different two types. Those are synchronous sequential circuit and asynchronous sequential circuit. When it is a synchronous, that means it is synchronized with a clock pulse. Here if you see the diagram, if the clock is connected to this, so your output will be produced that will be synchronized with the clock pulses which are provided. So it is called as a synchronous sequential circuit, because the sequence of the output will be get synchronized with the clock pulses provided. But when it is an asynchronous circuit, there is a no clock provided. So basically a circuit whose behavior can be defined from the knowledge of its signal at discrete instance of time is referred as a synchronous. And this discrete instance of time, that means the clock pulses given to that particular circuit. If a circuit whose behavior depends upon the sequence in which input signal changes is referred to as an asynchronous sequential circuit. That means irrespective of any time pulses, only if the input signal changes, your output will also change. So that is called as an asynchronous because it is not synchronized with any clock circuit. So basically we are going to see the different types of a flip-flop can be used. Those use the memory element. That means the bit information can be stored and then after some time, some delay, it can be reproduced as an output. In that you require the memory element. So such kind of devices can be called as a sequential circuit. So if the clock is provided, then it is known as a sequential synchronous sequential circuit, but if the clock, the device is not clocked, then it can be called as asynchronous. So we have a lot many devices which are work on a synchronous as well as asynchronous. So in the upcoming videos, we are going to see which are the synchronous sequential circuit and which are the asynchronous sequential circuit. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Do subscribe Ikeda. Thank you so much.